efforts to the City of the Living are well underway. People from all over the state have been arriving at the Jared Smith Center throughout the day. We expect that the convoy will move out sometime tomorrow.
His name was Otis. He said the police station was a safe house until it got overrun a couple of days ago, but he wouldn't tell me why they locked him up. Criminal or not, I couldn't just leave him there. I had to find a key to his cell.
Hey man, you gotta get me out of here. Don't just stand there. Go find that key.
Otis was sure glad to be free, but what would we do now? The radio said there was a safe house and an old theater nearby. We could go there, but the city streets were too dangerous to travel on foot. There were too many of those mindless walkers out there. My new friend Otis had a plan. Otis had an 18-wheeler cab in the impound lot. He would get it and pick me up, and then we'd make for the theater. My job was to cover him from the roof. First, I needed a rifle with a scope, and I was in the right place to find one.
Ha ha.
Otis was ready to run to the truck. I didn't have many bullets in the sniper rifle, so I had to be careful. I couldn't let a single one of them get to him.
You ready?
Go for it!
Otis barely made it to his truck when a bunch of them attacked. I saw him wave and yell something. All I caught was theater. And then he drove away. I was alone again. Otis had abandoned me. I had to find another way to get to the theater. It wasn't too far, but the streets were crawling with the living dead. I decided to get there through the sewers.
Yeah.
The theater was barricaded like a fortress, but everyone was dead. Those things got to them. I needed some rest. But first, I had some business to deal with.
Gentlemen, the Jared Smith Center for Performing Arts proudly presents Death of a Salesman, as performed by Dr. Hondo's interpretive dance troupe.